Having a good time tonight? Well, I'm going to put a stop to that right here and right now. Because my background, as I mentioned, is working in places like Coney Island, specifically in the sideshow. And I would like to do for you now an ancient honorable art that you don't see very often in our world today. I refer to, the art of sword swallowing. Ooh. Let me hear you go. Yeah. You don't see sword swallowing very often these days for three reasons. One, it is very dangerous. I will be shoving 2 feet of steel down my throat. Two, it is very difficult. I will be shoving 2 feet of steel down my throat. And the third and most compelling reason why you don't see sword swallowing very often is because no one really gives a damn about sword swallowing. It's true, and I think I know why. Collapsible swords. You see, we've seen these in movies and cartoons. We know that these things exist, and therefore, whenever anyone swallows a sword, a lot of people go, oh, it just falls up in the handle. That's how it's done. No. No, it is a real skill. It's the real deal. But don't take my word for it. I have a sword here that I'm going to swallow. The first one. This old blade, well, the handle broke off a long time ago. So there's no handle to fold up into. If this is going to go anywhere, it's going to go right down the gullet. But don't take my word for it that it's real. I can bang it around here so you can hear it solid. I can clean it off using a little antiseptic so it basically can be sterilized so that you, someone from the audience that can look at it and see that it's the real deal. But not just anyone, someone of dignity, sobriety, and old world charm. Someone that everyone can look to, someone that everyone can believe in. That's, you! You, the young lady right down there. Hi. Yeah, you. Yeah, yeah. Hi, yeah. I know you're part of the witness protection group. I'll tell you what, I'll come to you. Let me come down here, and what I want you to do is I'm just going to let you take a look. And hi, how are you? I'm just going to come to you, and I just want you to take a look at the blade and see that it's the real deal, that it doesn't collapse or fold. It's the real thing. They're just tapping. You see, it's the real thing. But, yeah, it's real. Yeah, the applause for the lady. She looked at the sword. That was significant. And still, after all that, there are some people who will sit there and go, well, no, it's not the real thing unless I see it. So therefore, for you doubting Thomases out there, I'm going to do it. And I'm sure you're going to be like all the other wonderful audiences. And when you see me shove this down my throat, risking my life for your entertainment, you're going to burst into thunderous applause, right? Thank you, both of you. The rest of you, I guess you got to wait and see. All right, fine. Here it goes, down the hatch, without a scratch. And there's some children in the audience. I'd like to say two things to you. First, don't go home and try this. And second, stay in school. Oh, look, my fever's gone down. There you go. Well, I know I appreciate your appreciation for that, but I have a feeling some of you are sitting out there and you're saying that you want more. I think you need more. I think you deserve more. Am I right? Then more you shall have. I'm going to do this again, except this time I'm going to make it a little more dangerous. That's the more part of it. I'm going to swallow this blade. This is what's known as a Moroccan kris. The serrated edge is created so that when you're fighting with it, the actual puncture doesn't kill your enemy. When you pull the sucker out, this edge is going to leave a wound so nasty that your enemy will die a slow, painful death from an infection several days, weeks, or months later. This is going to be a quiz, so I hope you're writing this down. Here goes. And the best thing about this one is that you can actually see my throat jiggle back and forth a little bit as it navigates down the serrated edge at no additional charge. Thank you. Now, I appreciate your appreciation of that, and yet, I have a feeling that you folks are sitting out there, and I have a feeling that you want more. I feel you deserve, you need more. I think you deserve more, am I right? And more you shall have. I'm going to do one last sword-swallowing feat here, and it happens to be the most dangerous and difficult of this whole skill set here. It uses this sword. It is not the longest, it is not the sharpest sword I have, but it is the most dangerous. Because of the design of this blade, there are three distinct dangers that I will encounter. Therefore, it makes it three times more dangerous than what you've seen me do. Danger number one, I'm swallowing a sword. People have died trying to do this. That's danger number one. Danger number two, I'm going to swallow this sword. See, it's got a solid bronze handle and head. It's a very heavy sword. Well, don't take my word for it. Let me just come down here and I just want her to take a look at it because I like this lady. And we're just going to come down here and she can take a look and see. Hi there. You see, this? Just take that. It's a heavy sword there. It's got some weight to it. That's a heavy sword. Is it? Yeah, they, applause for the lady. She looked at a heavy sword. That's significant. It'll be over soon. If this wasn't part of a work release program, I wouldn't be doing it. Anyway, now, as I say, so I'm going to be swallowing this very heavy sword because of the weight of the sword allows me to do danger number two, which is I'm going to start to swallow the blade, and then I'm going to let go and swallow it hands-free down the gullet like that. But that's not all. If you call right now, we'll also include danger number three, that while this is down my throat, I'm going to bend over and take a bow. Are you people listening to me? I'm going to take a bow with this sword down my throat. The technical term for that is cray-cray. It's totes ridic, but I'm going to do it for you because you deserve it. Am I right? There you go. And because this is three times more dangerous than anything you've seen me do, I'm going to get three times the applause, right? Thank you. I love you. I remember you in my will. Three times a day, so three times a month, okay? I just want to remind you, because see, folks, I'm doing this for you. I've seen this before. No. Hold it, save it for the end. See, I've seen this before, and I'm sick of it, but for you folks, I do it because for you, anything. I'm a giver, so here goes. And that, my friends, that's so swallowing.